Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK. And before we get into this video, I just want to wish everyone out there a very, very Merry Christmas, wherever you are in the world. And if you don't celebrate Christmas, whatever you're doing this time of year, I hope everyone is awesome, happy, healthy, and playing electric guitar as loud as you physically can. In this video, myself, Meg, and Sam will take a look back at 2021. It's been an interesting year for some very obvious reasons, but there has been some gems of 2021. We'll be talking about all of our favorite new gear which has landed in 2021, our favorite albums, our favorite gigs we've been to, as well as our favorite PMTVUK videos to shoot in the past year. And as always, everything will be linked in the description box down below. And as always, we love hearing from you guys as well. We've been sent a list of questions of our favorite things of 2021. So comment down below your favorite things of 2021. Like, get your answers on our questions, like your favorite gear, your favorite gig, your favorite PMTVUK video, and all that kind of jazz. We love hearing what you guys think, because the channel's kind of went crazy recently and we have you to thank for it. We've like hit up 250,000 subscribers recently. 250,000 people care what we have to say, which is absolutely crazy. Right, let's get to the questions. I'll go first because I'm here right now and I've glanced at them, but I haven't answered them in my head yet because I want them to be like the most genuine answers I can give. Also, I'll probably forget lots of stuff, but that's fine. My favorite piece of gear of 2021. Now, there's been some awesome gear of 2021, obviously. Big fan of the Lazarus, Joe Bonamassa, Epiphone 1959 Les Paul. All the Slash guitars, they were amazing. All the Slash collection, but Epiphone, not Gibson, that was awesome. Obviously, the custom graphic collection from Kramer. I'm a Kramer fanboy, as everyone knows. And yeah, it's been a great year for Kramer. All the Gunstar Voyagers and the Charlie Power signatures at the start of the year, and then these crazy graphic ones. Love them. ESP released the Alexi Laiho new guitars. I'm a huge Children of Bodom fan and Alexi Laiho fan, and unfortunately he passed away at the start of the year. And these purple guitars are just absolutely amazing. I'm yet to get my hands on them, but I've played Alexi guitars in the past and I love every single one of them. So these new purple and black ones tick it for me. Because I'm holding one right now, this is my guitar, my actually own guitar. I'm gonna have to say the custom graphic collection from Kramer. Hell yeah. Which PMTVUK video did I have the most fun making this year? Probably the going to the Marshall Factory. The Marshall Factory was amazing. Going to the Marshall Factory and the museum. Walking through the museum, seeing all these iconic amplifiers. If you haven't seen it yet, again, everything's gonna be linked in the description box down below. Went to the Marshall Museum and saw some of the world's most amazing, rare, beautiful amplifiers. Jim Marshall's first ever amp he made back in the day in a big glass case. It was crazy. Some prototypes that never even saw the light of day. It was spectacular. That was great. And the tour of the factory as well. That was awesome. But with that as well, that the day after, we went to London to Gibson's showroom. And we did a tour of the Gibson showroom in London. All the new Murphy Lab stuff, where you go if you want to craft your own Murphy Lab Les Paul. That was a lot of fun, checking out all these expensive Les Pauls and stuff. That was also great, but probably the Marshall Factory or the Les Paul video we did with Slash, the Epiphone Slash. We did a release video at Anarchy Brewery here in Newcastle. That was cool. So the Slash video, the Marshall Factory, or the Gibson Showroom. My three favorite videos of the year. What was my favorite album of 2021? 2021's been a good year for music, mostly because in 2020, everyone was stuck in lockdown writing, recording awesome music because we couldn't go outside. And that has been the case for some of 2021 as well. The last album I listened to today was a new album by LA Guns, Checkered Past. That's a great album. I'm a huge fan of Tracy Guns. Mammoth, WVH, Wolfgang Van Halen's new album. It's been nominated for a Grammy. That's one of my favorite albums of the year. Some obscure ones, like Demi Devil by Ash Nico. I'm a huge fan of Ash Nico. It's not really guitar-based music, but I think she's an absolutely phenomenal person, singer, and performer. She produced an album called Demi Devil. And Happier Than Ever by Billie Eilish. But I can show you, it's in my living room right now. I bought one of the Billie Ukes. Love this thing, love Billie Eilish, what she stands for, her music, what she records with her brother, Phineas. Happier Than Ever is a great album, and you can play some badass guitar too. If you learn the chords and you play guitar along with Billie Eilish's songs, awesome. That and last one I mentioned, Shadow Dancer. Jared James Nichols. It's more of an EP, but Jared's back and he's better than ever. And how can I forget Sob Rock? I was just about to answer the next question. I was like, oh, John Mayer released Sob Rock. Again, huge John Mayer fan. Every time he's been to the UK, I've always tried my hardest to get front and center to see him live. I managed it on two occasions, and Sob Rock is Bravo, John Mayer. Yeah, Sob Rock's an awesome album. Bit of gear I wish Santa would bring me this Christmas. Well, nothing under there is guitar shaped at the minute. There's a couple of chocolate oranges. But what I want for Christmas this year? Probably one of the ESP Alexi Lejo guitars. Old Kramer is always good. I love old Kramers. I could make my own Kramer Charlie Parra Vanguard Alexi Lejo tribute guitar. That'd be cool. Painted like black and pink. That'd be sweet. Or the Sinister Gates guitar. I did a video recently on the Schecter Sinister Gates standard, and that made me re-fall in love with the guitar because I used to have one way back when. So I'd really appreciate a Sinister Gates custom Schecter. Or one of the new EVH 5150 iconic amplifiers. I'm going to say ESP, Alexi Lejo, or EVH 5150 iconic amps, which have just been released. I haven't tried one yet, but I just know they're going to be amazing. What was the best gig I went to in 2021? I can't answer one answer for these, because there's been so many, and it's like asking a guitar player what his favorite guitar player is. You can't answer that question with one guitar player, because there's so many different influences which make someone awesome. You can't really say one specific guitar player. Favorite gigs? Biffy Clyro in Sheffield was amazing. I saw them a download a few years ago, but seeing them in a like, small intimate venue was awesome. I saw Ash Nico on the Demi Devil tour a few weeks ago. That was crazy. Amazing atmosphere at that Ash Nico show. It was absolutely kick-ass. And Hands Off Gretel. I saw a Hands Off Gretel show recently. I interviewed Becky Baldwin, the bass player for Hands Off Gretel and Fury, a couple of years ago now, just before COVID, I think. She's awesome. Lauren Tate is a singer. A fella plays guitar and he had a gimp mask on the entire night. And the drummer's kick-ass. And yeah, Hands Off Gretel, Ash Nico, and Biffy Clyro for 2021. What were my most played songs of the year? I haven't even got to check Spotify for this. My two most played songs of the year have been Don't Tell Me by Van Halen off Balance. A really, really left field Van Halen song, but the riff is just so cool. The drop D riff with the pick scrape and stuff. That's great. And Thank You for the Venom by My Chemical Romance. What was my favorite musical memory of 2021? I've played some awesome gigs in 2021 with my band The Reissues and other little things. My favorite thing was being asked by Kramer for the PMT event that we had in London at the Gibson showroom. At the Kramer Made to Rock Hard event, they got me a pedestal and I played people into the Gibson showroom for the gig that evening. So I was on a big pedestal playing loads of classic 80s riffs by famous Kramer artists while people were being entered into the venue. It was absolutely, so I've never done anything like that before. It was so cool. And to top it all off, Cesar Goykin, the Gibson chief brand president, awesome honcho guy was there. And Mark Agnesi was there as well, clapping me along, thinking it was awesome. So I was like, this is absolutely kick-ass. I never thought this would happen in my life, but it's happening right now. So don't miss a goddamn note. And I didn't, and it was awesome. So yeah, that's my favorite musical highlight of 2021. Now the last question, have I got any musical New Year's resolutions for 2022? No. I don't really like these whole musical resolutions, and so I probably do have some, but just keep working hard. Keep playing guitar, keep practicing. So, because I'm stuck in a box at the minute, if you notice, I play the same thing in every PMT video. So I'm trying to expand myself on that, because guitarists do get stuck in the box. No matter how good you think someone is, they do get stuck all the time and play the same thing again and again. So I'm trying to expand on that. But yeah, just keep grafting hard, because 2022 is going to be awesome for the PMTVUK YouTube channel. We have some amazing plans. COVID kind of halted everything a little bit and pushed everything back. We've got some amazing things on the way. I'm talking like breaking Guinness World Records kind of things. So those are my top picks for 2021. If you agree with anything I've been harping on about, please comment down below and let it known. Do you enjoy the ESP Alexi Lejos too? Do you want one of these Hot Rod Kramer Berettas? And how good is Ash Nico's Demi Devil album? If you're a fan of anything, comment down below. What's happened? Where's my fire gone? I know that fire needs another log. So this is a nice little segue. While I'm putting a log on that and putting a metaphorical log on my telefire, I'm going to send you down 250 miles, over 250 miles, to go see Sam and Meg at Portsmouth to see what they thought of 2021. See you in a second.
Hey guys, Sam here. Merry Christmas. Hope you're all having a good one. So yeah, Dagan sent me through a few questions for our kind of end of year roundup. So let's crack through a few of them. So right, first up, what was your favourite new bit of gear this year? That's a bit of a tricky one, that, because obviously it's been a weird couple of years for all of us, but there's still been some really cool stuff coming out this year. I'm definitely a bit of a Fender fanboy, and I would say that, you know, Fender have had quite a strong showing this year. Probably going back to, actually, it was probably the back end of 2020, was it? November, December time, they released the American Professional 2 series. And for me in particular, it was the Jazzmaster, because I reverted back to the original pickup switching options, but you still got the upgraded tremolo, that kind of thing. And I really liked one of the finishes that they brought out. Was it the... obviously Dark Knight, I think, was the one that everyone saw, that kind of bluey fade. But I really like the Inca Silvery, I think it's Mercury it was called. Yeah, kind of the old Inca Silver. I thought that looks stunning on the Jazzmaster. So yeah, still trying to persuade myself that I need that guitar. But more recently, there was the Jason Isbell Telecaster. Really like that guitar. I'm a huge fan of Jason Isbell. And that was a nice kind of understated signature model. Didn't really look like a signature. It was just a kind of 50s style Telecaster, so it's double bound and road worn. Yeah, really nice. Of course, there was the Super Reverb, the Tone Master Super Reverb. So that's joined the Deluxe and the Twin as part of the Tone Master range. As you can see, you probably spotted this in the background of quite a few videos recently. I've been using it for demos. It's a fantastic pedal platform. And because it's digital, obviously you can attenuate the power, but you still get that kind of original tone, or as close to the original tone as you can get. And of course, it's like the fraction of the weight of an original. That's a really good amp. Oh, and more recently, there was the Player Plus series that Fender brought out. Yeah, some great guitars. I mean, eagle-eyed viewers might spot at the back here. This is my Deluxe Player Nashville Telecaster. You might have guessed I'm a bit of a sucker for a Telecaster. And I kind of use this, keep it in the room, because it's a nice versatile guitar, three pickups, noiseless. But this one's been modified, so it's got a little switch on it. This is the kind of Fender Super Switch, so you can put the bridge and the neck pickup on at the same time. And the really cool thing about the Player Plus Tellies that have replaced this model is that you now get that as standard on a push-pull pot, so you get all those pickup options, but you don't have to modify the guitar.
Hey, it's Meg from PMTVUK, currently at the London store on my last shift before Christmas, and I've got a couple of questions to answer from Sam and Dagan. Firstly, what was my favourite bit of gear this year? Well, I've been thinking hard about this. I would say my top one was probably the Taylor AD27E that we got to review when it first came out. Oh, I absolutely loved that guitar. I wanted to take it home with me. I did not want to stop playing it when we were doing the demo. It just had such a mellow sound for a Taylor, which are normally really loud and bright and boomy. But the wood pairings with the sort of mahogany and the sapele back and sides, it gave it such a mellow but balanced sound. I absolutely did not want to put that one down. So I think that's probably up there. And I also did quite like the PRS Tonar in Lotus Pink that came out a couple of months ago. I think that one looks really cool. And I don't normally like a pink guitar.
Right, next question. What PMTVUK video did you have the most fun making this year? Now, one instantly jumps to mind, and that was our wireless shootout comparison, where, you know, we thought it'd be interesting to get a bunch of guitar wireless systems, cheap ones and more expensive ones, and put them through a series of tests to see which ones kind of performed the best. And I thought it'd be fun to obviously film myself walking around our store here at Portsmouth and outside on the industrial estate. So I asked my boss, I said, would you get me a GoPro so I could strap it to my head? You know, professional action cam, that kind of thing. He said no. So So I decided to make one out of a bike helmet and an old camcorder that I had lying about, which kind of worked. I was left with a big scratch on my forehead from the Velcro inside the helmet, and Meg said that I looked like a complete but yeah, that was a fun one. Oh, and of course there was a few weeks ago, got to meet up with Dagan for the first time. We went up to Strong Room Studios, myself, Meg and Dagan, and the other guys behind the scenes. Yeah, it's really nice to have a meet up and a bit of a natter. And yeah, for anyone who was wondering, Dagan is that good looking and charming in person.
Would you rather wrestle 10 duck sized me's or one me sized duck?
10 tiny ones, I think.
10 tiny ones or one me sized duck?
I can't imagine how intimidating that would be, just that giant, like,
tiny ones would be too cute, though, wouldn't they? Could you imagine, like, 10 little Dagans?
I reckon you'd love running around a bit.
Yeah.
Taking a run up.
I reckon.
Absolutely. Seeing how far you could kick it across the room.
I reckon Stuart Pearce penalty, yeah. Straight over there. Whack-a-Dagan.
Whack-a-Dagan, yeah. That's a great little PMT gift for next year, 2022. Whack-a-Dagan.
Oh, what video did I have the most fun making on the PMTVUK channel this year? Well, I definitely really enjoyed doing the wireless video with Sam, where he attached a GoPro to his bike helmet and we tested the range of the wireless unit by going up and down the industrial estate and around the local area. That was good fun. But I think for me personally, I had the most fun, or my favourite one would have been the Country and Bluegrass guide. I really enjoyed planning that one, shooting that one, getting one of my bandmates in to play some country songs with, got someone in to play slide, we got to feature banjo, all of my favourite instruments. I think that's probably the one I had the most fun making, as it was the most up my street. But I do love, in general, just shooting the acoustic content. That is all a bit of me. Oh, I'm leaving town tomorrow. Oh, I'm leaving town for good. And I don't want to say goodbye to you as I go. You are why I'm leaving. See, my mind has gone astray. Oh, I'm leaving town and I ain't coming back again.
Right, next, what was your favourite album of 2021? For me, I'm one of those people that I'm constantly absorbing new music. I love new music. So I can't really pick a favourite album. If there's been one good thing about this kind of pandemic, is the fact that where everyone's been locked down, there's been so many brilliant albums written over the past couple of years. I do know I was looking on my Spotify Unwrapped, and apparently the album that I listened to the most was by a guy called Jack Sims. He's a kind of singer, songwriter, self-producer from, I think, California. The album, I think, was called Tompkins Park, and it's a kind of lo-fi, folky, electro kind of album. Yeah, it's really good. Similarly, I really got into a guy called Francis Lung, released an album called Miracle, I think it was called. And it's quite eclectic, again, singer-songwriter. But yeah, quite an eclectic kind of mix of styles. So it's a little bit kind of folky, a little bit rocky. It's kind of like a mishmash of the Beach Boys with Ben Folds and Elliott Smith, with like some crazy kind of Brian May guitar solos over the top of it. Yeah, that's an album worth checking out if you're into that, any of those, basically. Who else? Right, I probably just better rattle through a few. What I've been listening to recently that I've been loving: The Staves, Good Woman. That's a great album. Loads of really good songs, amazing vocal harmonies. I've got into Julian Baker's new album. I really like her guitar style. She makes some really interesting really interesting choices when it comes to melodic stuff on the guitar, with some kind of great use of effects. Sufjan Stevens, he just released an album that I fell in love with instantly, which was a collaboration actually with a guy that I've not heard of before. Is it Angelo D'Augustine? I hope I got that right. But yeah, if you like early Sufjan Stevens stuff, so kind of Bon Iver, that kind of thing, it's back to his kind of acoustic folky roots. That's really good. Griff Rees from the Super Furry Animals, he brought out another great solo album. Love Griff. That's Seeking New Gods, which is kind of a weird concept album written about a volcano. Like that one. Teenage Fan Club released a really good album this year. Never Really Let You Down. They've been around for years and years if you're into kind of lo-fi indie pop. Oh, and yeah, Tori Amos. Believe it or not, I mean, I'm a huge Tori Amos fan. I always tell people that I'd like to be able to play my guitar with as much beauty and kind of aggression as Tori Amos plays a piano. I've been massive fan of Tori for years and years, but she released a lockdown album called Ocean to Ocean, which was kind of written and recorded, I think, transatlantically. So she lives in Bude, I think it is, or somewhere down in Cornwall. And it was, recorded over the internet with her band over in the States. It's a real kind of harking back to her original couple of albums. Yeah, beautiful album. So, I can't really pick one. But if you're looking for new music, go and check out any of those albums. They're all brilliant.
What was my favourite album of 2021? That is a great question. I think I definitely absolutely loved the Arlo Parks album, the Claps in Sunbeams one that came out right at the beginning of the year. I thought that was great. Great songwriting, very topical. I just touched upon a lot of things that I resonated with. I also loved the new Jordan Rakai album, What We Call Life. I've had that on repeat since the summer. And actually, that leads me on nicely to what was my most played song of the year. Well, according to my Spotify Unwrapped, I listened to Family by Jordan Rakai off What We Call Life album. Far too many times. That was by far my most played song. It's a great track if you haven't heard it. Family by Jordan Rakai, definitely be my most played song.
What was your most played song of the year? Mine's... it's probably a couple, actually. Well, according again to my Spotify Unwrapped, the story behind it, my most played song, I totally binge watched Sons of Anarchy about 6 months ago. Like, literally just smashed out 7 series really quickly. And obviously, for anyone who hasn't seen a show that finished like 10 years ago, I won't ruin it with any spoilers. But there's quite a significant thing that happens in the finale, and it's the song behind it is a song called Come Join the Murder by the White Buffalo. And thinking about it, watching that show is probably why I let my hair grow and I grew a stupid beard. The White Buffalo Come Join the Murder, I play quite a lot, and it's a great song, don't get me wrong. Really good guitar solo in it, well written song. It's not something that I'd ordinarily go and listen to. It's either that, or I think I listened to a song called quite a lot called Chinatown by Bleachers. And again, it's not by artists that I'd necessarily gravitate towards straight away. It's Bleachers is a guy called, is it Jack Antonoff or Antonoff? Something like that. I'm sure we'll correct it in the comments if I'm wrong. But he's one of these kind of super producers who produced, you know, Taylor Swift and Lorde and people like that. But he does Bleachers, which were a very kind of indie pop band, as a side project. And this track, there's something about it. It's kind of a little bit 80s inspired. It's a great song, but it's also got Bruce Springsteen on it. Again, not an artist that I would say that I'm a massive fan of, but really brings something with his vocals and the way that he sings a melody. So yeah, Bleachers, Chinatown, and the White Buffalo, Come Join the Murder. Yeah, great songs though. What bit of gear would you like Santa to bring you this Christmas? I have got my eye on something at the moment, actually. Basically, recently I've been soundproofing my shed at the bottom of my garden because my missus is just sick of me playing guitar in the house. Actually, probably my neighbours as well. So I needed somewhere to go and play and make a little bit of noise. The only problem is it's really small. It's kind of like 5x7, tiny little shed. I've been soundproofing it with acoustic plasterboard, all that kind of thing, and it seems to work quite well. But I do need a little amplifier that's going to sound good to sit in there. And remember, it's not a new product, but the Boss Katana Air was a really good little thing. And obviously, it's got the little wireless unit and things. So it'll be a really good one to kind of fit in a corner. And it's stereo, so it spreads the sound really nicely. The only thing I'm a little bit worried about is obviously it's been out for a couple of years. And all of the other Katanas are now on the Mark II versions, except for that one. So I might just hang on a little bit, unless Santa does know if there's a Mark II version coming out, in which case, I'll have one of those, please.
Oh, what bit of gear would I like Santa to bring me under my tree? I would really like one of those Nashville Telecasters, particularly the one in like the blue opal sparkle. I think that's the colour they call it. I don't normally get too invested into the electric products that come out. I'm definitely more of an acoustic player, but this year, those Nashville Telecasters, I absolutely fell in love with them. I think the single coil pickup in the middle is a great addition. It adds some real bite, which is perfect for someone like me who loves country and bluegrass and Americana, folk music, all of those sort of twangy sounds. If that could be placed under my tree on Christmas morning, I would be a very, very happy bunny. Yeah. But I take any of the Player Plus Nashville range Tele or Strat under my tree. Father Christmas, yes please.
What was the best gig that you went to in 2021? I didn't really go to many gigs, if I'm honest. I think obviously lockdown at the beginning of the year and everything that's been going on, it's kind of, I haven't been to that many gigs. I saw Griff Rees, who I mentioned earlier on. He played at my local kind of venue, which is the Wedgwood Rooms here in Portsmouth. That was a great show. Really love Griff, and he played that album that I mentioned, the Seeking New Gods album, in full with a band. It's always really interesting to see him because he's for anyone not familiar with Griff and the Super Furry Animals, which is the band previously, they were quite an experimental indie rock band, and he's totally bonkers. It's always really interesting to see him because he's a left-handed guitarist who plays a right-handed nylon string guitar upside down. So yeah, just from the kind of musical geek point of view as well, watching him play and see how he's playing chord shapes and things upside down, yeah, crazy. But no, I really enjoyed that show. Fantastic show.
What was the best gig that I went to in 2021? I think for me, that would have to be Laura Marling at the Brighton Dome. She played like old songs all the way up to new songs, and she played every single one of my favourite tunes of hers. She's one of my favourite songwriters in the world, so I really loved that gig. It was emotional, it was moving, it was so intimate. It was just her on stage, and the last few times I saw her, she'd had the whole band, so I really enjoyed the stripped back acoustic set and all the old songs that she played. I think that probably be my favourite gig of the year.
What was your favourite musical memory of 2021? As I said earlier, it's been a weird year. Obviously, there hasn't been many gigs going on or anything like that. If I'm honest, and it's probably what anyone would say who plays music, it was actually being able to get back on stage and play. Again, I haven't been super active gig-wise. Played the last gig of the year, probably the last gig of the year, last week. And that was a good, fun kind of Christmas show. And I played, did a few sets at our local festival down here, which is called Victorious Festival. If you've not heard of it, it's quite a big festival, like kind of 80,000 capacity. But it's also quite unique. It's right on the seafront here, down on South Sea Seafront in Portsmouth. That was a really good weekend. And I remember one specific point in the weekend where I'd finished playing, the sets that I needed to play for that one day, and I kind of was a little bit overwhelmed maybe by it, because obviously where we'd all been kind of locked up for a little while, it was just weird to have so many people around. But it was a beautiful day, the sun was going down, I had a couple of beers in my bag, so I thought I'd go and check out a couple of bands, and actually ended up sitting on top of a hill with the sea behind me, overlooking probably around about 25,000 people, something like that, on one of the main stages watching Reef. And Reef are a band from my kind of teenage years, which, I've got a bit of a soft spot for them. It was one of those kind of really nice moments. Had a couple of beers, someone's going down, they were playing, the greatest hit set. And for a moment, everything felt kind of back to normal for a little bit. So yeah, that's probably my favourite musical memory of 2021.
My favourite musical memory of the year, it has to be being able to do the festival circuit this summer, especially after the year in 2020 of not being able to do it and not being sure whether we were going to get gigs back this year. I think getting to, as I imagine everyone felt, when we got to June sort of time and the festivals were going ahead, so grateful to be back on that run, grateful to be tired all summer, to be on the road all summer. It was fantastic. That was definitely my favourite musical memory of the year.
Right, this one looks like the last question. Have you got any musical New Year's resolutions for 2022? Yeah, I think I do actually. Obviously, I want to get my shed finished that I was talking about, so I've got somewhere to go and play a bit more guitar at home. I want to get some more gigs. As I say, I didn't really get too many gigs at all this year. I think I mentioned earlier, Tori Amos is touring for the first time in years with a full band. So yeah, I'd like to get up to London and see her. Granddaddy, one of my favourite bands, they're doing a few shows next year with an orchestra, so that should be quite an interesting one. Yeah, so definitely get some more gigs. Oh yeah, there is one more thing actually. This is probably going to be quite a controversial thing to say, and I'm sure I'm going to get loads of shit in the comments for it. But a few weeks back, when myself, Meg and Dagan met up, I was chatting to Dagan about something. As a lot of you guys will already know, he's a huge John Mayer fan. And I was saying how I don't really get it. I've listened to a lot of John Mayer stuff, and I appreciate he's a fantastic guitarist and he's adored by most people in the guitar community, but yeah, I just don't get it. He does nothing for me. It's just so kind of bland and cheesy. I don't get it. I can see it now, all you keyboard warriors. Here we go. Oh no, don't read the comments, Sam. No, okay, I'm gonna try. That is my musical resolution for 2022, is to try and understand and get why people like John Mayer. If you did want to leave me a comment below to kind of let me know which track I should properly start with John Mayer, or just to let me know what you think of my opinion that I'm sure you're gonna not agree with, yeah, go nuts. Anyway, that's it from me. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you're all having a really good Christmas. Look after yourselves, stay safe, and I'll see you again in 2022.
And have I got any musical resolutions for 2022? Yes, you know what, I do. I am finishing my album off in 2022, so for me, a big one is to get that done, hopefully by the summertime, have all the parts done, the artwork is done, but we need to get all the parts finished, all the mixing done, and I'll have that done by the summer. I'd also really like to get a bit more stuck into the behind the scenes production stuff, mixing and working on my own music at home. I definitely started getting into it quite a lot in lockdowns, but this year being busier and gigging, I have not had as much time for that. So one thing I'd definitely like to work on next year is getting more stuck into production and producing my own songs, working on them at home. And I think my final resolution would be to collaborate more. I love collaborating, but I get stuck into the sort of reclusive songwriter mindset of working on my own at home, and next year I definitely want to make sure that I collaborate with far more people. But yeah, overall I'd say a great year, and I have really enjoyed being part of the PMT content team on a regular basis this year, and I look forward to taking the acoustic content further next year and continuing to be the female face of the PMTVUK channel. I hope that everyone has a fantastic Christmas and a happy new year, and stay safe and healthy.
So there we have it, ladies and gents, what the PMTVUK crew thought of 2021. Meg had some fantastic answers, Sam had some fantastic answers, up until the point that he said that thing about John Mayer, which I do not really get. Sam, my 2022 resolution is now the same as yours, to make you fall in love with John Clayton Mayer. The dude's a legend. Right, everyone besides Sam though, please comment down below your favorite bit. And like I said at the start of this video, we want to know your favorite bits of 2021. So your favorite piece of gear, your favorite PMT video that you've seen me, Sam and Meg in, or your favorite album or favorite gig. Just let us know, because we like knowing stuff, I guess, because it's a nice little community we've got here at PMTVUK. And like I said, it's gonna get bigger and better for 2022. So hit subscribe if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in the new year. Stay safe, look after yourselves, have a good one.